The CBS Sports family of networks. The highest standard in sports television. Including the CBS Sports Network, Showtime Sports, CBSSports.com, and the CBS Sports Radio Network. The best in sports online, on radio, and on the air. CBS Sports. Expect it here.
These are the faces of the future of American volleyball. The top 24 high school seniors from all corners of the USA are gathered in Seattle. You will see them all in the collegiate ranks, playing for top programs at the highest level. Future rivals or teammates for a star-studded night at the net. The Under Armour All-America Volleyball Match and Skills Competition is front and center on CBS Sports Network. Welcome in to the Emerald City, Seattle, Washington, where tonight it's the Under Armour All-America Match and Skills Competition. Along with the legend, Karch Karai, I'm Landrum Robertson. Tonight we will showcase the best and the brightest and the future of college volleyball. And Karch, that's what's so exciting. All of this talent on one court, under one roof, showcased here tonight. And the future of college volleyball is very, very bright.
And it sure is. What a legit game this is. Just 3 years ago, Deja McLennan, as a freshman, led her Penn State team to the national championship and was the most outstanding player of that NCAA tournament. She played in this game the year before. Last year, Lauren Carlini, a huge star now for Wisconsin, played in this game, and now she's led Wisconsin to the national title match. It doesn't get any more legit than this.
Well, I want to talk about two of those future stars that we're going to showcase here tonight, and we're talking about Haley Washington. She's very good, and her teammate here tonight, Courtney Swan.
And Haley Washington has the name that might keep her here in Washington, but instead she's going to one of the legendary coaches and programs to play for Coach Russ Rose at Penn State. And Courtney, of course, has decided to stay right here as a local hero and play for the University of Washington. Future stars of the game here tonight.
All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, buckle up. It's going to be exciting. A lot of talent here in this building, and it's the Under Armour All-America Match and Skills Competition. And from beautiful Seattle, it's coming your way next. The Under Armour All-America Volleyball Match and Skills Competition on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Bodden, the official court volleyball of the AVCA. Welcome back to Key Arena, Seattle, Washington. And now it's time to meet the third member of our team, and it's Megan Piché.
All right, it's a big night here at this high school match. Lots of energy here in the arena, and we're gonna go ahead and kick it off and get you to some rules of tonight's play. So the game is going to be 3 sets to 25, rally score, so not a best of three, so we're gonna play 3 sets no matter what. We'll be playing NFHS high school rules, so nothing new for these girls here. And also part of tonight's events, we will have 2 skills competition, one for best setter and one for hardest hitter. So it's going to be a big night. Landrum, we'll take it back to you.
Let's meet the starting lineup for the East. Now let's meet the starting lineup for the East.
Allie Franti, Richmond Burton High School, Spring Grove, Illinois, Penn State.
Simone Lee, Menominee Falls High School, Menominee Falls, Wisconsin, and I'm committed to Penn State University.
Lauren Gillis, Newcastle High School, Newcastle, Indiana, and University of Southern California.
Louisa Shermer, Pittsford Sutherland High School, Pittsford, New York, The Ohio State University.
Beth Nordhorn, Winter Park High School, Winter Park, Florida, University of North Carolina.
Nia Reed, Immaculate Heart Academy, Fort Lee, New Jersey, Penn State University.
Haley Templeton, Chattahoochee High School, Johns Creek, Georgia, University of Miami.
There's a good shot of Kim Lowers, the head coach at Diamond High School, Anchorage, Alaska. And wow, look at those stats. Four of the last five Alaska 4A championships have belonged to Kim Lowers. And now let's meet the team from the West.
Kat McCoy, Carroll High School, South Lake, Texas, University of Texas.
Alyssa Gaynor, Lakeville North High School, Lakeville, Minnesota, Marquette University.
Haley Washington, Doherty High School, Colorado Springs, Colorado, Penn State University.
Brittany Abercrombie, La Costa Canyon High School, Carlsbad, California, University of Southern California.
Stephanie Ipley, Round Rock High School, Round Rock, Texas, Texas A&M University.
Courtney Schwan, Bellarmine Prep, Tacoma, Washington, University of Washington.
Chrissy Jones, Los Alamitos High School, Los Alamitos, California, University of Washington.
And it's Jody DeGroat, the head coach for the West, and she has won the last two Washington 4A championships and has, of course, Courtney Schwan playing for her here tonight. And it should be exciting. And we look at the referees for tonight's competition, and Paul Jensen and Kay Wendell Adams doing the officiating for this event in front of a great crowd here in Seattle. As you look at the team colors, Team East will be wearing the yellow. Good-looking Under Armour jerseys, and the West wearing the pink. And the West will start things out here in set number one. And Allie Franny hammers that one home for point number one.
He sure did. That was a big arm right off the bat.
That time it was Lauren Gillis out of Newcastle High School, Newcastle, Indiana. She's going to play her college ball at USC, the Women of Troy. Hitting error that time as the ball goes out of bounds, and Team West.
It's amazing at dinner how loose these two teams were. They were getting along great and having East cheers and West cheers and giving themselves all the team signs. They've gotten together very quickly in their short time here in Seattle and really gotten some, developed some nice camaraderie.
Yeah, talking with Jody DeGroat before the game, I said how much strategy can go into this, and she said not very much,
but exactly.
It's just good that we've gotten the girls acquainted.
They know each other's name.
That's right. And they're going to try to go out and have a lot of fun tonight.
And they're keeping it simple offensively, and that's what you want to do when you're just getting to know the people around you.
And Simone Lee cannot handle that one from Alyssa Gaynor, from Lakeville North High School. So Kat McCoy. And the kill is awarded to Team East. Right there at the net was Haley Templeton out of Johns Creek, Georgia, Chattahoochee High School. Now
Nice job of the left that time, and it's another point for Haley Templeton and Team East building on their lead. They now have a one-point lead.
And that's a quick way to score points if you're a left-handed setter and you don't know that many people around you and the other team doesn't know that much about you. Throw it into the corner for a kill.
And you're going to see that possibly a lot. The middle blocker for Team East. As you see her here, she is all of 6 foot six. And her name is Beth Nordhorn, and she's going to play her college ball for Coach Joe Segula at the University of North Carolina.
And boy, putting that height to advantage. One of the nice things with those long legs, long arms, is you don't necessarily have to jump very high. When the ball gets set in the middle, she did a nice job of getting hands across the net for the point.
Brittany Abercrombie. Serving and the finesse shot.
Good hustle.
And hammered home, Lauren Gillis from Newcastle High School. Good look at Lauren Gillis. She's East leading by two here. And just set number one of this three-set match. And I ain't able to get that one up. That time was Courtney Swan, who we talked about in the opening. And Karch, your observations here early on with these two teams.
Well, the thing you have to expect is a number of misconnections as they're getting to know each other. So all the defenders have to look for something like that. The off-speed shots, the tips, and the, I guess, the squib plays that come through. And so I think both teams are doing a nice job of being ready to play forward and keep those defensive plays in the air.
And it's an ace for Haley Templeton. And a timeout is on the floor. Team East leading Team West here early, 9-4 in set number one here of the Under Armour All-America Match and Skills Competition here on CBS Sports Network. And welcome back to Seattle. Under Armour All-America match here in set number one. Team East leading, but still very early, 9-4. Haley Templeton coming off an ace. Franti can't save that one, and it's a point for the West team. Alyssa Gaynor.
And she might even be considered a little undersized as an outside hitter at only 5'10", but I like what she's doing, using her height, reaching high when she contacts the ball, hitting the edges of the block.
Yeah, just two players under 6 feet tall between both of these teams.
Boy, they are growing them taller and taller.
They sure are. And right there in the middle, number 26, and Chrissy Jones.
And even though they're taller, it doesn't mean that they're then having less, speed and quickness to the outsides. Not only are they getting taller, but they're staying just as quick. Nice move by the middle there, Chrissy Jones. And there's that misconnection that I was telling you about, another one. So lots of off-speed shots. If I were a defender playing in this game, I'd be playing way forward, knowing that those hitters and those setters are still trying to figure out how to connect with each other. They only had a couple of practices to get ready for this.
So the West has battled back 9-8. Our score here in set number one. Two early timeouts. So how much strategy is going on between the two benches right now? with Coach Groat and Kim Lars. But right now, we're going to go to Megan. She is standing by with a very special guest.
I do have a very special guest here. I have three-time NBA champion Judd Bushler. Now, Judd, you're here as a spectator today. Your daughter, Riley, is an All-American. Congratulations. Just must be a really proud parent moment for you.
Thank you so much. Yes, it's a super fun night for me. Obviously, all these girls have put in so much hard work. A lot of time away from other activities, and it's just a great night for me right now.
Absolutely. Now, did she play basketball too? Did you try to push her in that direction, or was she a volleyball the whole way?
She actually loved basketball. She played in sixth and seventh grade and was a pretty good player, but once the volleyball got more and more serious, as it does now at those ages with club, she had to really just focus on that.
Absolutely. And you played a little bit of sand volleyball yourself, right? So are you analyzing game film after tonight's game with Riley later on?
Probably not. But, yeah, I grew up playing volleyball on the beach in San Diego and played some indoor as well. So coaching club volleyball right now at Wave Volleyball Club. So we talk a lot about volleyball. I've been her coach since she was nine. So it's great stuff.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for being here. Congratulations to you and your family.
Thank you so much.
So Judd Bushler. Wow, it was so much fun to watch him. He played on some pretty special teams in the NBA.
The team that he coaches is not a bad squad. They've got two other Olympians, Brent Hilliard and one of my all-time favorite teammates, Steve Timmons, as the other coaches of that club team. They're quite a lineup there with those two and Mr. Bushler.
There's another talented kid that's going to go play for Penn State, Simone Lee, and she hammered that one home. And it's Lauren Gillis that is long with that serve. So the West trailing by three and serving. And Chrissy Jones, her goal is to play on the Olympic team. She says, Sander, indoor, it doesn't matter.
Well, that's an emerging game. In fact, it's designated as a developing sport at the NCAA level. It's almost got enough schools already signed up to become a full-fledged, fully sanctioned NCAA championship sport. But it's going to be tough as more and more sand players get into it. People are going to have to make a commitment earlier and earlier. Do I go the indoor route or the sand route?
And I think a lot of these student athletes, as they head into college, a lot are just saying, you know, I want to diversify and, you know, give myself the most opportunities to play either one.
And they are different seasons. Wow.
That's Haley Washington, and that's why we talked about her in the open, Garch.
She delivers some heat cross court. And a nice connection there. Again, just trying to get her to know her setter. And a nice connection there with number 17, Stephanie Eichley.
And Eichley can't come up with that one. So 15-10. Here in set number one, as we take a look at the replay.
Yeah, Eichley was lined up just with a hair, a little bit of space down the line. Couldn't face the action and keep it on her side of the net.
Simone Lee also signed with Penn State.
You're going to be saying that school a lot, Penn State. We've got five athletes all told.
Incredible.
Talking about in this game tonight.
Reloading. Wow. Allie Franti, another Penn State signee.
She opened the evening up with a kill and bringing some more heat there.
I'm sure it takes a certain type of player to play Penn State volleyball.
It sure does take a certain type of player. I was at the college All-American banquet, and one of the All-Americans was Ariel Scott from Penn State. She was asked, well, what'd you learn from coach? She said, well, pretty much not to be a baby. you're not gonna be a success in life if you're a baby. So he definitely doesn't sugarcoat things, and he's won a lot of commitments from this talented group tonight.
The really interesting thing is you look at Coach DeGroat there on the sideline, but reading the bios of some of these players. Three of them that are that have signed with Penn State played football when they were younger.
That's certainly not for the faint of heart.
Kat McCoy, the shortest player on the court at 5'7", from Southland, Texas. Oh, and a shoe comes off of number 19, Courtney Swan.
And they gave her the replay call. I love it.
I love it.
The libero, Kat McCoy, number two, yelling at the referee, come on, give us the replay, and got it.
It's an all-star game, right?
Exactly. Let them play. Oh my gosh, we're having shoe incidents all over the court.
You have to tighten up the laces. And look,
they're all tightening up.
DeGroat, Coach DeGroat has her entire team relacing their shoes. And now the team from the East has caught on. They're doing the same.
Third time's a charm.
That's right. Oh, beautiful finesse by Lauren Gillis.
I certainly like how she adjusted to that. The ball goes wide. You see her falling to her left, and she found a way to keep it in. Not only keep it in, but get it to the floor for a kill.
She'll be playing for the Women of Troy next year. Gillis, once again, that's back-to-back solid plays from Lauren Gillis.
A good view of how she finds the space inside the middle blocker, hitting that sharp angle shot.
Well, Nia Reed with a service error. Very, very talented family, and we'll talk about that family tree in just a little bit. It's a service ace for Abercrombie as Haley Templeton can't come up with it.
Yeah, she contacts that ball. She uses her height at 6'4 to her advantage. She's almost hitting it down, and it has very little spin, a little bit of what we would call a hybrid, something between a knuckleball and a topspin serve.
Point for the West. So trying to keep it close. Trailing by three, but serving. Nice job by Swan to keep it alive.
Ooh, fair enough.
What a rally. And let's talk about the play, the shortest player on the court, number two, Kat McCoy.
Maybe short in stature, but not short in skills. The big part, the big challenge in playing good defense is just making the ball hit you. She did it several times in that one rally and earns her team the point.
You see why Coach Jarrett Elliott wants her on his squad next year.
She'll be a big help in terms of the kind of defense she offers, the kind of ball control, the kind of control she has on when the opposing team is serving. That's an important part of a strong offense.
Well, Simone Lee, who's headed to Penn State, lines up with Beth Nordhorn on the right side of the net, and they get the stuff, but That's followed up with Haley Templeton and a service error. So Alyssa Gaynor, a six-time All-American.
Wow, that's a lot. I didn't know you could get more than one a year. That's impressive.
Six times. Allie Franti, this season, 603 kills, Karch.
And these are the easiest kind. When you get such a tough serve that the ball comes back over the net by about a foot, it has the right spin, and all you have to do is find the open floor.
And as you see, where they're headed, no surprise, the Big Ten leading the way, but it's interesting to note that five of those players are headed to Penn State. Pac-12 representing as well. The SEC, a little bit surprising to me. They have four of these players playing here tonight in the Big 12, ACC, and the Big East.
Yeah, and if you look at the College World and the College Tournament, those are really the four premier conferences. They earn the most seeds out of the top 16. Only the top 16 out of 64 in the tournament are seeded. And the Big Ten, the Pac-12, the Big 12, the SEC, the dominant schools in representation and in postseason success.
Louisa Shermer is wearing number two. In the gray, there's a libero. A libero. And it's a service ace. Libero. How do you pronounce it?
I pronounce it libero, but potato, potato. All I know is East is serving really well right now, and they're at set point, creating another scoring opportunity, a tight set, and a stuffed block. That often happens when you set the ball too close to the net.
Yeah, that's going to be it. And Nordhorn at 6'6", got her hands up there, as well as Haley Templeton. And so the East takes set number one. Two more to go. Right here from Seattle. The Under Armour All-America Volleyball Match and Skills Competition on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Sports Imports, the official net system of the AVCA. Welcome back to beautiful Seattle, Washington for the Under Armour All-America Match and Skills Competition. Landry Roberts along with Karch Cry and Karch Simone Lee. She is looking strong here early. She certainly did in set number one.
Four kills, only one error in seven attempts. When you hit, we take the kills minus the errors and divide by the total and figure out what the percentage is. And anything above 300 is a very effective hitting efficiency. She's hitting at almost 430 so far this set, this match.
Well, it's a point for the West, who are wearing the pink uniforms provided by the good folks at Under Armour. The East wearing the yellow. Oh, what finesse that time. I know you like to see that.
I sure like to see the hustle from Gaynor over on a confusion play. After she served, creating a scoring opportunity, the ball almost fell to the floor. You're going to have a lot of that where teams struggle to communicate as they're just getting to know each other.
Been very impressed with Gaynor here early on.
Absolutely. Mobile in the backcourt, and even though she's not as tall as some other hitters, hitting effectively so far in the front.
That was Christina Ambrose with a point for Team East. She's 6'4", also from Winter Park, Florida. Played with Beth Nordhorn, who stands at 6'6". What's in the water down in Winter Park, Florida?
Apparently growing a lot of good volleyball players down there.
Certainly are. Brianna Weiskircher. One player we will not see tonight is Ashton Smith-Gooden. And had a great season. 387 kills. A 482 attack percentage. And you hated for that young lady not being able to play in a showcase in an event like this. Marion Hazelwood. Serving. Member of the 2013 USA Junior National Team is Hazelwood. And a hitting error called on the East, so another point for the West, and the West leading here early in this second set. Judy DeGroat. Head coach of the West from right here in Washington. Christina Ambrose, you see the power of the 6'4 outside hitter.
It's interesting, everybody's so tall, nobody really looks 6'4, 6'3, 6'6. And they're all looking quite mobile too. Good lateral movement.
Courtney Crable serving for the East. Crable is going to play her college volleyball at Auburn. Four SEC signees on the court tonight.
It's got to make you a little fired up there.
Mind seeing the Gatorade Kentucky Player of the Year heading down to the Plains. And another point for the East. So they pull to within three and already leading one set to none. Back to serve, it's Nia Reed. Enjoyed speaking with her before tonight's match, but there, an unforced error. Courtney Swan checking back in. Riley Buschler. And too long from Haley Washington. You saw the power, but just too long. Riley Buschler, didn't know, she is double jointed in both of her elbows.
And that's probably gonna help her form a nice angle of what we call a platform, and she did one right there. Put the ball right on the money. When you can straighten your elbows farther, you can form a better forearm platform.
Does that help with the back set?
It helps with the forearms. I don't know about the setting, but it sure gives you some mobility there and make a really flat surface.
The wonderful things you learn.
Yeah.
In an all-star game.
The other interesting thing to watch is just how everybody's communicating between plays. A big part of volleyball is how do you make those around you better? How do you elevate the play of those around you? And it's a really big challenge in this format because they've had so little practice together.
On a hitting error by Carly Snyder. Mother, father, and sister, all college athletes, and we have a timeout on the court, and we will take it to breaks. So the West leading the East 10-5, and the East leading one set to none here in beautiful Seattle, Washington. Lydia Demke there from Blaine, Minnesota. She's going to play her college ball at Purdue. A scuba diving instructor. Swims with sharks. Oh, look at the power. Marion Hazelwood.
Yeah, I sure like her work there. That's a hard job to do. She was blocking. You have to come down, get off the net quickly, and approach right back and be available as a hitter in transition. Nice work by Hazelwood.
Courtney Swan from right here in Washington.
And that play was really made by the libero McCoy, number two for the pink side. There was confusion. He called out, I'll take it. I'll make that second contact. She put up a nice hittable ball.
Courtney Crable with a backcourt kill, and she will check out. She is replaced by Christina Ambrose, the 6'4 outside hitter from Winter Park, Florida. Carly Snyder serving for the East, and nobody home.
Had these players been together for, another few practices, maybe another week, I think that ball comes up. Just everybody's waiting for somebody else to make a play on that. And that ball dropped into the middle.
And Nordhorn with the stuff. But it goes out of bounds, and it's a point for Team West. Callie Aiken, Kansas 4A Division One Player of the Year, serving.
Well, I like what the setter Demke did there. That ball was almost going over the net. She elevated, kept it on her side, and allowed her attacker to do the job.
Louisa Sherman serving. Born in Germany, dual citizenship. Ashley Reeser for the touch. So the West pulling away from the East here in set number two. Oh, goodness. Oh, goodness. Mia Reed.
You give somebody that good an open net with just one blocker, she should have a lot of success. Be careful.
Play at the net. Lydia Demke. Can't get it over for the point. So the West has doubled up the East. 16-8. Trailing the East 1-0. Haley Washington, quite the battle there at the net with Nia Reed.
She's definitely doing a good job of keeping her teammates loose. Got a smile on her face, good celebration. After getting the ball down.
The future Oklahoma Sooner, Marion Hazelwood serving. Stuff at the net by Christina Ambrose. Nia Reed also credited. Courtney Crable wants to be a physical therapist, as we mentioned, Kentucky Player of the Year. It's back season. Yeah. Cross court cutter right there, Ashley Reeser. I know you like to see that, coach.
It's a tough play to defend because she's a left-hander, and often people will over-travel. They're so used to blocking right-handers on that side. Left her a lot of cross court, and she took advantage.
All right, right now we're going to throw it to Megan Pichet. She has a special guest standing by. Megan?
I do have a very special guest with me right now is Courtney Schwann. Courtney, great job already tonight. You are playing excellent. You're here in front of your hometown crowd. What's it like to be in your home state and play in front of your friends and family?
It's awesome. There's a lot of support out here, and they came out to support, and it's awesome to see all the love that you can get at Washington. It's just great.
And you're headed to University of Washington next year. How do you feel about that? Are you excited?
I'm so excited. And especially like last night, we came out, watched the semifinal match, and there's so much support here. You get so much love as a dog. And I'm so excited to put that uniform on my back next year. It's going to be great.
Wonderful. And you have a lot of support here from your teammates, too. This is a fun game here to play with a bunch of top-notch volleyball players. What's it like to play with the best of the best and be on the other, see on the other side of the net those players with, you know, blocking those other big hitters from across the country?
It's awesome. The more competition, the more fun.
Wonderful. Well, thank you so much, and best of luck.
Thank you.
Good job. Thank you.
So Courtney Schwann, back-to-back state titles, playing for Coach DeGroote here in Washington. Head coach of the West team, Riley Bushler. For the point, Ashley Reeser serving. Haley Washington.
Team Pink, Team West has come up with some good celebrations already. They only needed one or two practices, and they got it down.
A lot of chemistry. Well, Coach DeGroote, she said her team, if anything, they were going to come out and they're going to have a lot of fun. She said, I don't know about strategy, but we're going to have fun, and it seems that they are having a lot of fun here at Key Arena tonight.
And ultimately, we play this game. We don't drill this game. There should be moments of great enjoyment, and these athletes have worked really hard to earn the help their teams and earn the kind of accolades they have here. So it's definitely, oh, what a nice hustle play. There, my McCoy. They should earn this. They should enjoy this.
Carly Snyder.
And I think they got the touch call. Point for the East.
Carly Snyder is committed to Florida. Wants to be involved in broadcasting one.
He'll be taking our job soon enough, right?
Well, one of our jobs. I think you're safe.
Yours.
I think you're safe, legend.
Is safe, I was going to say. Ooh, nice shot.
Just why?
Like the defense from Reeser back down the line. When you play defense down the line, you're at short range. It's not on cross court. You don't have much more time to react. So it's really important to get in a good spot and point your arms up.
Swan's hit runs long. Lydia Demke serving. A Blaine, Minnesota product who will be a boiler maker next season. Was that ball tipped?
That was not touched, and that might still be going if the coaches weren't there. You'll see when there is no spin on the ball, that's usually the sign of a mistiming, miscommunication, and that's exactly what happened.
Hammer is good by Ashley Reeser.
Taking the West to set point, 24-13.
She played for Mike Smith, who was honored earlier today by the ABCA for reaching the 700 win milestone. Oh, what a pretty shot by Courtney Swan. So, set number two goes to the West. So we have a third and final set coming up here from Seattle. Stick around. The Under Armour All-America match continues right after this. The Under Armour All-America Volleyball Match and Skills Competition on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Bodden, the official court volleyball of the AVCA. Beautiful Seattle, Washington during the holidays, and it's cold outside, but Karch Karai, the energy level, the excitement is here inside Key Arena. Wow, you take a look at the fans enjoying themselves. This has really turned in to be a great event just to showcase all of the talent at the high school level. 24 All-Americans, and we get to see the future. And the future looks bright in college volleyball.
And they're playing on the same court in the same venue, the same arena that the NCAA championships semifinals and finals are held each year. What a thrill for these players, many of whom, some of whom, could be playing for that NCAA title a year from now as freshmen for their various universities.
And Under Armour, the sponsor of this event, they do such a wonderful job promoting their product, not only sponsoring this event, but in between sets, the crowd interaction is wonderful. A lot of Under Armour merchandise going up into the crowd. And what better way to spend your holiday than going to underarmour.com and purchasing your loved one some great Under Armour gear.
Absolutely. Good idea for a gift. And now, with the score tied 1-1, somebody wants bragging rights.
Courtney Swan.
And that's how she ended the second set, with that same roll shot. She gets her elbow back and makes it look like it's going to come really hard, one of those 50 mile an hour heaters, and then it drops just behind the block.
Too hot to handle. As Brittany Abercrombie has a point for Team West. So two straight points to start off the deciding set number three. Unforced error.
Yeah, well, actually pretty forced. That was a very good serve by Eakin there. Aiken really has gotten her team out to a great start. She is hitting that jump float serve, and it's very hard to control. A lot of movement on that, just like a good knuckleball pitch in baseball.
Christina Ambrose could not handle the last
one. There's another one coming out with two aces. Got her team off to a great start, 5-0 in this third set.
And Lauren Gillis couldn't handle that one. She's checked in at the libero role, wearing number three, a gray jersey. Five-one West on top in the third and final set. Coach DeGroat told us before the game, we're out here to have fun, but now when you're tied 1-1 final set, maybe the strategy changes.
the last one. Before the game, they were having some great cheers, and each team was trying to do it, get the best of the other in terms of the cheers they had going. Now they want to get the best of each other on the volleyball court.
Alyssa Gaynor with the serve. And it's Nia Reed with the point. Her mom played basketball, her dad ran track, and her grandmother ran for the United States track team.
Wow, Miss Bushler delivering some heat. There's a lot of space to hit at in that between the outside hand of the outside blocker and the antenna. That ball has to go inside the antenna.
Haley Templeton, what did you think about that play? As Templeton got it in between the West defense. Trying to keep this one close here in the third. And deciding set. But every time the East scores, the West has answered. Abercrombie back to serve. Also played soccer and softball. And a service error that time.
And I think it's actually really good for a lot of these athletes to have played and competed in multiple sports. Often, especially in this day and age, it seems like lots of athletes specialize sooner and sooner. But I think it's really good for their long-term development to work on different movements, different ways to make each other and make teammates better in those various sports before they specialize, as they will, as they do now, and as they will in college.
Yeah, Abercrombie and Carlsbad, California, will be attending the University of Southern California.
And just not doing the same movements all year long is going to keep them healthier, too. So I like that. I like hearing all those other sports.
Brianna Weiskircher with a long serve, but I really like Brianna Weiskircher. You know, played competitive football when she was younger. And she is one tough kid out there on the floor. And she's going to be a welcome addition to that Penn State Nittany Lion Club come next season. Strong but long by Simone Lee. Another Penn State signee. Out of Menomonee Falls, Wisconsin. Service ace. Lauren Gillis can't handle it for Team East. And a timeout is called by Kim Lowers. Her team trails by five here in the final set. We're coming back from Seattle. Stick around. Welcome back. Bushler serving with her team leading by five. And once again, we're going to head to the third part of our broadcast team, Megan Pichet. Hello, Megan.
Hey, guys. I'm here with another very special guest. I have Haley Washington. Haley is going to Penn State next year. She's one of the most charismatic girls we have here on the court. She's living and dying with every point. Are you having fun here or what?
Oh, my gosh. I'm having an absolute blast. I'm going to be playing against these girls for the next 4 years of my life. I'm just so excited to be here and just enjoy my time. It's just such an amazing and humbling opportunity. It's awesome.
And lots of your future teammates here today. Mm-hmm. Five of you going to Penn State. That is pretty incredible. Are you excited to play with those girls next year?
So excited to play with those girls. It's really funny because they're all on the East team, and I'm the only Penn Stater on West, and we always joke about it, but so excited to be playing with these girls. They're incredible.
Wonderful, and you're an incredible player as well. What are you going to study in college?
Thinking about either kinesiology and going into the chiropractor field or communications and doing this. I really like that.
All right, wonderful. Well, you're going to steal my job someday. Perfect. All right. Thank you so much for being here. Congratulations on being an All-American, and best of luck in your college career.
Thank you so much.
All right. We'll kick it back to you guys.
Thank you so much, Megan. Of course, Haley, another one of the players out there today that revealed to us in her bio that, yeah, she played football. I like her intensity, though, her spirit. She seems like she'd be a lot of fun to have as a teammate.
That's an important thing to have in volleyball, for sure. The best players make those around them better, and it's literally fun to be on the court with somebody who makes you better.
Simone Lee with the hammer, but just wide of the line, so Kat McCoy back to serve. Lee tries again, and once again unsuccessful, but this time she's stuffed by Courtney Swan.
Returning the favor, she had just stuffed Swan a couple of plays ago. Now they're even.
We are not even in this third set. West leading 15-7. Gillis with a nice job of saving that one. And Ashley Reiser with a strong left. 708 kills this season, coach.
From the back row, she's been effective for that, and I like her vision. She saw a lot of line there. Took what the block gave her. And then makes the defensive play.
Allie Franti. Able to get that one to go. Can be handled by the West defense. But a service error there, so not much momentum being put together here in this third and final set by the yellow team from the East.
What a nice play by Team West. All three contacts there. Great hustle. Getting the ball up in the air for a swing, and Bushler with some nice aggressiveness from about 10 feet off the net.
And I'm not sure why Riley Bushler wasn't the hardest hitter. We're heading to break. Timeout on the court. The Under Armour All-America Volleyball Match and Skills Competition on CBS Sports Network is being brought to you by Sports Imports, the official net system of the AVCA. Welcome back. As you see, downtown Seattle, we are inside Key Arena. A good look at Team East. It's the Under Armour All-America Match and Skills Competition the third and final set. Landra Roberts along with the legend, Karch Karai. So glad that you could join us here on CBS Sports Network. The West team wearing the pink, the East in the yellow. And it's Simone Lee trying the shot down the line, but it's wide. And the West threatening to just run away with this one.
Yep, Aiken got him going early. And she's on another service run here, but it's really not so much she's doing as the hitting errors from Team East.
Allie Franti, another example of just what you said there, Karch. Oh, it's in. Allie Franti, I think she thought that ball was going to go past the line. It caught just inside and was awarded the point for Team West.
Good rule of thumb. If you don't know whether it's going in or out, play the ball, put it up in the air, let your teammate make a set.
Tally Akins with a service ace.
And Aiken, that one she definitely earned. That's a very short serve. Tough play to make for Team East with time running out, only 3 points away. And another ace.
Coming over towards us. Another ace. Callie Aiken, Kansas 4A Division I Player of the Year.
What a blocking move by Courtney Schwann, taking her team to match point.
Well, now I think we've seen why we highlighted her in the opening of the broadcast. She is showing out in front of the hometown fans here in Seattle. Templeton. Back to serve. Templeton, the 2011 National Player of the Year. Going to play her college ball for the Canes at Miami. A shot by Snyder. Reeser with the left. Team East just staying alive.
Just today, Coach Lowers was talking about her Alaska team, and one time they were down 24-10 and came back to win. So anything's possible, and there is an ace.
Match point.
Chipping away. Staying alive.
Coach Lowers, she has done just an incredible job there in Alaska with her volleyball program. 4 out of the last 5. State titles, but that's going to do it. Team West rallies to win the 2013 High School All-America match here in Seattle at Key Arena. When we come back, the skills competition coming your way. Stick around, more to come from Seattle. Well, another big part of this event was the skills competition. And the setting competition took place first, and competing it was Stephanie Iplee, Haley Templeton, and Lydia Demke. They all had 45 seconds to see how many balls they could place into the net. And next, it was the hardest hitting competition. The contestants were Allie Franti, Haley Washington, and Lauren Gillis, and they were being measured by the speed gun. When we come back, we'll see who was named the MVPs of the 2013 Under Armour All-America Match and Skills Competition from beautiful Seattle, Washington. Stay tuned. Welcome back to the 2013 Under Armour All-America Match and Skills Competition here from Seattle Key Arena, the site. And tonight, it was Team West defeating Team East 2-1 to take the Under Armour All-America Match title for 2013. And now it's time for the MVP award. For the East, it was Lauren Gillis. She's going to go and play for the Women of Troy next year at the University of Southern California. Meanwhile, for the West, Ashley Reeser. She's going to College Station. Tonight, she accounted for 6 points. She'll be playing her college volleyball at Texas A&M. So right now, we'll throw it to Megan Pichet. She is standing by with both of our MVPs.
All right, I am here with the most valuable player for the East team, Lauren Gillis. Congratulations. Talk about the game tonight and how that felt.
Oh, it's just amazing because there's so many great players here, and it's just great to be able to become friends with them and play with them, so it's been awesome.
Well, congratulations. Well deserved.
Thank you so much.
All right, let's give it up for Lauren Gillis. Okay, and now with me here from the West, the most valuable player from the West, Ashley Reeser, congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, talk about the game tonight. How did you feel? Was it just fun to go out there and play? And
yeah, it was a lot of fun to play with all great athletes from all over the nation. It's fun playing at a high level like that. We're like all best friends already. We laugh all the time. I just want to say thank you to everyone for giving us all this opportunity to play in this game.
Yep. Thank you so much. Congratulations to both of you. Thank you so much.
Well, what an unbelievable night it was here in Seattle at Key Arena. Lots of excitement, and the future of college volleyball could not be brighter. For Karch Karai, Megan Pichet, and our entire crew, I'm Landrum Roberts. For scores, highlights, features, and more, go to CBSSports.com. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports.